I've got to confess, ladies and gentlemen, I started my career over 20 years ago as a science teacher. And I just can't resist ringing the bell. Now, you can see on stage here with me a gentleman you probably recognise, but if you don't, Mr. Silverman, said he, Director General. And in a moment, he's going to take the floor and share his journey of innovation over the last few years. Before he does, I want to remind you of two things. I mentioned at the start this afternoon, we had seven steps to take us through this journey of innovation and capturing value. After your break, which I hope you all enjoyed, we're now at step five of seven. We're going to hear from Silverman first, who's going to present to us this journey I mentioned. We're then going to convene our panel to really look 360 degrees at this idea of how can the industry really capture lasting value through innovation. And we'll finish off proceedings today for a nice 5:30 prompt finish with me interviewing the incoming separate chairman to ask for his reflections on what we've seen this afternoon. So without further ado, Silver, I'll hand over to you.
Thanks, David. Okay, good afternoon, everybody. I could feel over the coffee break some energy, the good old pony magic, maybe. So my challenge is to bring back again the level of energy to introduce the panel discussion. And to do that, I thought it may be interesting to start back to the future. This is a little bit of the journey I would like to pay tribute to my predecessors at SAPI. And we're part of this journey. Where in 2011 we made a roadmap looking at how does it take to decarbonize and create value in our industry? What could be the path to move forward? And from that roadmap, we looked at the technologies 3 years later. And I will come back to the technologies in my presentation. And then we also looked at the innovation in design, innovation in materials, innovation in products. And then we looked at the investments, and that's what we discussed with you last year. That was my first European Paper Week. I had a challenge to explain to people that you're going to have to invest 44 billion euros in Europe by 2050. And from there, we did this. We issued in February a investment transformation roadmap that looked at the different paths, the different investment platforms that needs to be looked at, and the conditions industry needs to make this transformation happen. I will not repeat the story there, but I'd like to share with you the two type of questions I got. I got two kind of questions when I presented this to policymakers, to industry people, to academics, to NGOs. Silva, that looks so great, but where is it happening? Where are the products? How will I finance this? How are we going to accelerate this? These were the kind of questions I got a year ago. What was for me very interesting, I didn't get any why question. I didn't get any what questions, which means that our industry is maybe a little bit more aligned behind this vision than people may think about. But fair enough, where, how? And over a year, I've been looking around Europe at the where. I see the transformation happening, where the products are, how we can make the investments happen, how we can make the transformation accelerate. And this is a little bit of this journey I'd like to share with you. Where is it happening? When I got this question at the European Commission with one commissioner in March, I thought, we need to go faster. We need to pull together examples of investments our members have been doing over the past 2 years across Europe so that we can document where the investments are happening. And the where those investments are happening, it's north, south, east, west of Europe. That's the important thing. It's not limited in one single geography. It is a transformation that touches different countries, different ecosystems, different industry